Subscribe now and press the bell icon. Never miss an update.
Watch download and installation of CSI Bridge version 23. Click on card link showing top right of video.
In this video, I will show you how reaction forces act on tower and anchors in horizontal and vertical axis to resist loading of suspension bridge. What is suspension bridge? A suspension bridge is a bridge in which the deck is supported by cables that are suspended from, typically, two large towers. Vertical suspenders attach the deck to these main spanning cables. These cables are continuous over the tower supports and are firmly anchored at the ends of the bridge by, for example, huge blocks of concrete. The towers typically rest on concrete caissons in the water. The dominant loads in this structure are gravity loads, the dead load of the bridge deck, and the live load from the traffic carried by the bridge. Wind loads, though important for the analysis, history, and design of suspension bridges, will be neglected in this study for simplicity. The loads from the deck are transmitted by the vertical suspenders through the cables to the tower foundations and the anchor supports. This analysis will focus on the reactions on the tops of the towers and the anchors. Because of the great number of suspenders, we can approximate the short-spaced gravity loads as a uniformly distributed load on the main cable. The total vertical reactions acting at the tower are due to loads that act on the main span, between the two towers, and on the back span, between the tower and anchor. First, we will examine the effects of the main span and then we will examine the back span. The applied gravity loads on the cable are acting downward, therefore the towers need to resist these forces with upward reactions. The vertical reaction due to the main span Vm at each tower is Vm equals QL over 2. Where Q is the uniformly distributed load applied to the bridge in kip per foot and L is the length of the main span of the bridge defined as the distance from tower to tower. In addition, the loads on the bridge act to pull the tower tops toward each other. These forces are resisted by horizontal reactions in the cable at the top of the towers to keep the towers vertical. The horizontal reaction due to the main span, HM at each tower is HM equals QL square over 8D. Where D is the vertical distance from the top of the tower and the cable is greatest. It is called the sag of the cable and it is located at midspan, center of the main span. Let's now solve example to calculate main span tower reaction. Determine the vertical reaction in each tower and horizontal reactions in the cables at each tower. Of the suspension bridge due to the main span dead loads plus live loads. Dead load of the bridge is 39 kip per fort. Live load of the bridge is 8 kip per fort. Main span length of suspension bridge is 3,500 feet. Sag of cable is 325 feet. Total load acting on bridge is dead load and live load. So, it is 39 plus 8 equals 47 kip per fort. Vertical reaction at each tower due to main span is Vm equals QL over 2. That is Vm equals 47 into 3500 over 2 equals 82,250 kip. Horizontal reaction at each tower due to main span is HM equals QL square over 8D. That is HM equals 47 into 3500 square over 8 into 325 equals 221,442 kip.
Watch pedestrian suspension bridge main cable analysis and design. Click on card link showing top right of video.
The gravity loads on the backspan must also be supported by the towers. This analysis assumes that no other external horizontal force acts on the tower, such as wind. Therefore, the horizontal reaction in the cable at the top of the tower for the backspan, HB, is equal and opposite to the horizontal reaction from the main span, HM. By summing the moments about the anchor, the vertical reaction due to the backspan, VB at each tower is where HB is the horizontal reaction in the cable due to the backspan, D is the vertical distance from the top of the tower to the anchor, Q is the uniformly distributed load applied. to the bridge and LB is the length of the backspan. Let's now solve example to calculate backspan tower reactions. Determine the horizontal and vertical reactions in one of the towers of suspension bridge due to the backspan dead plus live loads. Dead load of the bridge equals 39 kip per fort. Live load on the bridge equals 8 kip per fort. The backspan length equals 650 feet. Vertical distance from tower to anchor equals 377 feet. Total load acting on the backspan of bridge is sum of dead load and live load. So, it is 39 plus 8 equals 47 kip per fort. In this case, first I have to determine horizontal reaction HB, for that first calculate reaction HM on tower due to main span of bridge. So, HB equals HM, that is HB equals 221,442 kip. Now calculate vertical reaction VB, due to backspan of bridge. Using formulae of VB and input all values I am getting VB equals 143,711 kip. The total vertical force that the towers support equals the sum of VM and VB. That is, those loads brought on by the main span plus the back span. Therefore, for this example, each tower carries 82,250 plus 143,711 k equals 225,961 kips of load in compression.
Watch how to add moving vehicle load, vehicle path and lane in SAP 2000. Click on card link showing top right of video.
To maintain horizontal equilibrium, the horizontal reaction in the anchor must have the same value as the horizontal reaction of the backspan. Summation of H equals 0 equals HB minus H anchor. So, it's H anchor equals HB. To maintain vertical equilibrium, the vertical reaction in the anchor must balance the upward vertical reaction from the tower and the downward gravity loads of the backspan. The vertical reaction in the anchor, V anchor is thus summation of V equals 0 equals VB minus V anchor minus Q into LB. So, it's V anchor equals VB minus Q into LB. Let's calculate anchor reaction. Determine the horizontal and vertical anchor reactions of the suspension bridge which we used in previous example. From previous example reaction, I have horizontal reaction on tower due to backspan, HB equals 221,442 kip. Vertical reaction on tower due to backspan, VB equals 143,711 kip. Load on bridge, Q equals 47 kip per fort. Backspan length, LB equals 650 feet. Horizontal reaction at anchor is H anchor equals HB equals 221,442 kip. Vertical reaction at anchor is V anchor equals VB minus Q into LB. That is 143,711 minus 47 into 650 equals 113,161 kip.
Want to see how to model suspension bridge in SAP 2000? Click on card link showing top right of video.
If you need any assistance in structural engineering, or you want your structure to be designed, you can contact me through email address engineer.uzer2014@gmail.com. Do like, share and comment below in comment section. Also subscribe, and press bell icon so you will never miss any new video.